Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. So today in this vlog, we'll talk about something very important. We will tell you our experience of traveling to Europe from UK by car. If you are planning to go to Europe from UK, there are multiple options. You can take a flight, you can go by Eurotunnel, or you can take a ferry. And if you're taking your car, you have to go by either Eurotunnel or by ferry. We chose to go by ferry. So in this vlog, we will tell you our experience of traveling to Europe from UK in a ferry and back. So our plan was to visit Brussels, Amsterdam and Bruges. All of these are in the west part of Europe, so driving made sense and it's cost effective. You can imagine a flight ticket would have costed us a bomb, because we were four of us with luggage for 5 days. It would have costed a lot. So this was a very cost effective option, and we will tell you the details of our costs in the end of the video. I had many questions in my head and I tried to find videos on this on YouTube, but I couldn't find a good video on the experience you will have while driving to Europe. So my attempt here is to give you the maximum information related to traveling to Europe in a ferry. So if I have missed something, please comment and let us know. And of course, please don't forget to subscribe.
We had booked Irish Ferries for this travel. Irish Ferries ticket had the address, so we are just following that address and going to the Dover port. From Dover port, we will find the Irish ferry, and from there we will board and travel to Calais. The lanes here are marked very clearly. When you reach Dover, just look for your ferries lane and look for car lanes and you will reach the point.
So we are in a queue.
This is the queue for French border control, where our passport and our Schengen visas were checked. You also have to provide your international COVID pass. The immigration was done. We were provided the slip, which basically means all clear. We are ready to board the ferry. We were also provided the lane number by that lady over there when we were passing that area. Try and reach a little bit earlier because you might find long queues. We are simply following all the boards, all the markers that are taking us towards Irish Ferries, which is our ferries. Very easy to follow, very good instructions everywhere. At this point, our passports and ferry tickets are being checked for the final time before we board. We were also provided the card for our lane. Our lane is 103 that we were asked to hang on our front shield. We are now going towards the boarding point, and just to show you, this is how the place looks like. You can see the lane numbers are marked very clearly. Just keep following these numbers. Ours is 103, so we will continue going towards 103. The last guy who checked your details would have also provided you a boarding pass. This is how the boarding pass looks. This is the final queue to board the ship. You can find the departure board just like the one in the airports. We are taking the Irish 655 to Calais. We are patiently waiting in the queue. This is the container that we are gonna board. That's our ferry. Now we are finally getting in the ferry. We will reach the parking area first. The parking is just like any other covered parking, just like you see in the malls, etc. So it is nothing too complicated inside there. We have parked and we are on the upper deck of the ferry. The ferry has now left at Dover port and sailing towards Calais. There is a proper restaurant in the ferry for breakfast. We chose to take the full English breakfast, which was about 12 or 13 pounds. Giving you a quick tour of what it looks from inside. There are the cafes, there's a reception, and now I am going towards the duty-free shopping area.
You're a duty-free shopper. Ship ke andar ye duty-free shop hai. Chota sa. Decent hi hai. और हम लोग अभी शिप पे पीछे डेक पे आए हैं
और मजे ले रहे हैं सी का व्यू,
और हम जा रहे हैं
We have reached the Calais port, waiting in the car to get out of the ship. The odometer has already been changed to kilometers and we are all set to drive on the right-hand side.
It is a historic moment for Shashank in his life. For the first time, he's gonna drive.
Right-hand side.
I think it's a front car.
It's gonna be very, very exciting.
So this was the first time for me as well where I drove on the right hand side of the road. So it was not difficult. I thought I was nervous, but it was not difficult. Whenever I used to take a turn, I would remember that I'm taking a turn and I would remember that I have to go on the right hand side of the lane. So that was not very tricky. When entering the roundabout, you have to check on the left and not right. So that's one thing you have to be very particular about. And you enter anti-clockwise in a roundabout. So that was a bit weird, but then you get accustomed to it.
Of course, because it's a right-hand driving, the slip roads are coming on the right, which is one of the major differences. This bit is when we were returning from Calais to UK. We are at the Calais port, ready with our passports for the checks. Again, follow the signs, follow the boats very clearly. It's marked which are the car lanes and which is for which ferry. We are on this lane because this is for Irish ferry and this is for cars. While coming to Calais port, Google Map confused us a little bit in the last few minutes. So please follow the signboards because maps might not be updated properly. While coming to this queue for the ship, there were two checks that were done for us. One was French Border Agency that checked our passport and the tickets. And then there was a second check done by UK Border Agency where our passport, BRP, which is our proof of residency in the UK, was checked. We were also asked what was our purpose to visit UK.
We are still at Calais. And
वेदर के कारण डिलेड है हमारा फेरी
डेढ़ घंटे से ज्यादा से ऐसे ही बैठे ये देखिए आप ये स्नो है ये आइस है बहुत बुरा हाल है शशांक बात बात कर रहा है फिगर आउट कर रहा है क्या हुआ है स्कॉट मी अ कॉफी
तो गाइस हम लोग अभी भी फंसे हुए हैं
और शशांक के वेंडिंग मशीन से कॉफी ला के दिया है जस्ट सो दैट इट्स वेरी कोल्ड ओला पड़ा है तो यहाँ बहुत ठंड है
ये देखो आप पूरा स्लीट जमा हुआ है ये आइस है और हम लोग अभी और एक घंटा फंसे रहेंगे
और हम बना रहे हैं YouTube वीडियोस क्योंकि हमने सोचा हम 4-5 घंटा वेस्ट नहीं कर सकते सबसे फनी बात ये है कि शशांक और मैं 4-4, 5-5 लेयर पहने हुए हैं क्लोथ बट
फिर भी ठंडा लग रहा है हाँ
आप बाहर गाड़ियों का क्यू आपको शशांक दिखाएगा कितनी बड़ी है और ये हमने इतना सारा वीडियो दिस इज ऑल द वीडियो दैट वी हैव टू ऑर्गेनाइज एंड स्टार्ट एडिटिंग नाउ सो प्लीज डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब प्लीज वी वर्क रियली हार्ड टू एंटरटेन आवर सब्सक्राइबर्स
द एक्सपीरियंस फ्रॉम Calais to Dover and Dover to Calais wasn't bad really, but the weather was unpredictable. It started raining, there was ice, and that delayed things for us. However, just wanted to show you how long the queue is. We are still waiting at this point to kind of board our ship, and we are delayed by 3 hours now. So guys, just wanted to quickly use the opportunity and show you this services kind of setup here. In Calais, and I think Dover also has it, they have this proper services with toilets, vending machines, you can get soup, coffee, etc. And it's quite warm in here. So just in case next time when you are traveling, you could use these services if you need to use the water.
Very, very, very glad to leave France. As glad, I think more glad than we came here.
very glad to leave France.
Like the last time, it's just like any other covered parking. So we are parking our car inside.
On the deck now.
We are on the ship now. The water was very turbulent, so we could feel it in the ship. We could feel the waves in the ship. Everything was literally like falling on the floor of the deck because the ship was shaking so much.
काफी टेढ़ा हो चुके हम लोग. इतना टर्बुलेंट है कि लग रहा है सब ठीक है चल रहे. सब लोग गिरते पड़ते जा रहे हैं, बहुत टर्बुलेंट है पानी.
And finally, we have reached the Dover port, which is in UK. This is the parking. We are going to sit in the car and now drive all the way back to home. There were no checks done at the Dover port, so you leave pretty quickly for the motorway.
I am sharing a list of France, Belgium, and Amsterdam. If you are planning to visit some other country, please check the requirements for that particular country. Would be your BRP passport, car insurance, and your V5C document, which provides the details of the owner of the car. Specifically for France, you need to have a yellow life vest in your car for each passenger and breath analyzer. So I got these two from Amazon, and you would need a UK sticker that also I got from Amazon. The rules have changed. You don't need a GB sticker, but you need a UK sticker now. So please check, and if you have a GB sticker, replace it with a UK sticker. Whatever country you are driving in, check the road signs, the important road signs for that country. It might be in a different language. So please do check and remember those. So our car has a steering wheel on the right, meant to be driven on the left hand side of the road. Basically, it's a UK car meant to be driven in the UK. But I was driving this car in Europe, not only on the wrong side of the road, but also sitting on the wrong side of the car. So it was a bit tricky for the first 15 minutes, but I can assure you, it's not difficult. You have to be cautious at every turns you take, every roundabout you enter. Just be very cautious. When you drive in UK, you don't think when you take turns, but there you will have to think twice before you take a turn. Just follow the lanes. It's not difficult. It will just take 15 minutes for you to be accustomed to the driving situations. So guys, if you have liked the video, please share and comment. Let us know what was your experience, and if I have missed anything, please put that in the comment section. I hope you guys have liked the video. Please subscribe. 75% of the people have not subscribed, so please do subscribe and keep watching our videos. Bye.